I would like to introduce you someone. The whole Friday sermon would be the introduction of one person, one who, whether he's a person or something else or just a guy, one of the, that one is our major, our primary enemy. I want to introduce you our primary enemy and his tricks and how he wins, how he defeats us. That one, he interferes us, he goes inside us, he changes our minds, our way of thinking, and he destroys our decisions, and he diverts our plans. And he always, he is alert 24/7 just to take us out of the right path and take us to the wrong path. So he uses any means possible, anything that he can succeed in his mission to divert us from the right and lead us to the wrong. That one, hopefully you understood, that is none but Shaitan. So Shaitan is that one who we are in struggle with the Shaitan and our wicked deeds, our wicked soul that is also influenced by the Shaitan. So now that's a very huge topic and it needs a lot of explanations. But I just want to highlight in this lecture that to mention some of the gates that Shaitan uses in order to enter us, to intervene our decisions, and to whisper in us. This one, Shaitan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him this authority. Even though he is the enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has given him this authority to whisper in us and to change our plan and to influence us to the wrong way. Why Allah has given him this opportunity? Someone could argue, say, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created me and loves me, how come he gave authority to his enemy to influence me? It's a very simple answer, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created many, many creatures. Many creatures are in the world, in the universes, in everywhere. And all of those, each one of them, Allah has given him an authority. One authority or more. And at the same time, he gave them a free will. And at the same time, most of them are culpable of what they do. They are responsible of their actions. Especially human being and the demons, the jinn. Those two have the responsibility of whatever they do. If they do wrong, they will be demerited, they will suffer from the consequence of their wrong deeds. And human being also the same thing. If whatever we do, if it is right, we will get the rewards. If it is wrong, we will get the consequence. And now, so Allah has given us authority over the nature, over the animal, over the plants, over among us. So then Allah is testing us with all that. And then the same authority, in another way of authority, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave other way of authority to the Shaitan, which is that Shaitan is made of fire. And Allah, so we cannot see him, he is among us, in between us, he goes inside us and he tells us something. And then he changes our mind. And when we change our mind, we change our action from positive to negative. And then that authority, the same one, which is physical, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. So then we have to know that the shaitan is one of the creatures of Allah. And Allah gave him this authority. But then what is the wisdom behind that? The short answer is that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create us and then tells us everything, and there's no shaitan to influence us, there's no problem, and we see that everything as real, then there will be no need of creating paradise and hellfire. Because everyone is already right, and there is no accountability, there's no reckoning. Then because Allah should test us in order to be qualified for His paradise, His Jannah. So in order to get that qualification and that degree of entering the eternal life, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should make us, give us a test, a trial. And then if we pass, then alhamdulillah, we will inherit the Jannah. If we fail, then that is the problem of the individual. As we fail, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who pass that exam. So, and Allah has given those different authorities, and that is why we are, for two reasons, that we are in test, and the other one is that we also have other authorities over each one of us, that the one, anyone that you are stronger than him, then you can beat him. So that's the authority. You can kill the animal, you can do all that, but it is there's accountability of whatever you are doing. So how, let us focus on how shaitan enters us. There are many gates that shaitan uses. And those gates, we have the key of those gates. And we are inside that building. And shaitan has other keys, and he's outside the building. So it is you. The doors and all those gates are in you. If shaitan is able to enter you, then he will make his room inside you. He will get his bedroom, his dining room inside you, and then he lives there. Because you have the key, and the door is here. You have to lock it. When you lock it, the door, he has another key. When you go inside, and you forget a little bit, you do something else, and you're busy, some other stuff, he will come and open. And then, if you allow him to enter, then he will stay there and sleep. How is that? That shaitan is, we have thinking always. Our thinking, he tries to control our inner thinking, our also innate capacity, internally. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who controls all that, but he was also given the opportunity. Because first, when when he was casted out of the Jannah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, you will be the first one to enter the hellfire. And then that's when he said, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, give me a portion of your people. I will influence them to the wrong way, and I will make sure to draw them to the hellfire. And he said, ثُمَّ لَأَتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. I will come to them from all the corners. I will come to them from the right hand, the left hand, and then from the front and behind, and you will not see most of them that they are thankful to you. And then I will lead them to the hellfire. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the answer and said, anyone who follows you, and you will be in the hellfire. And there are many ayahs in the Quran. So our focus is his entrances. First of all, we have to know that Shaitan, wherever you go, he will come in front of you and he will whisper in your ears, and then he will try to put something bad in you. And that is, it is scientifically proven now that in front of the nightclubs, if you go to the nightclubs and where there are people who go, who deal with the stuff of the genie, diamonds and those stuff, very terrible places. Those places, Shaitan sits there. And people who come there, then he will just enter to them like smoke. And that is scientifically proven. The scientists have proven that there are small things that are alive, but invisible, and they go to the people's nose and ears and mouth. They go inside to them. And those things are like larva going like this. They are typically like what we can call the worms. Those small worms, and sometimes they go bigger, they become almost like small snakes, and they go into you, like if one is smoking, you can see the smoke going like that, huge. Same thing like that, they go into like smoke, so they go inside it, because they are made of fire. So usually, they are, the microscope shown that they are intestinal parasites, like those round worms, which are like ascaris. Same like ascaris, they go inside. So that shows you, it is not only Shaitan that can go into you, it's also living things are living in you, because the larvae and ascaris and many other things, lymphocores, they live in you, in your body. And they are visible, they are physical alive, sometimes they are bigger. So that's where they're from. You are, they live inside you. Why not have something which is just a fire and you cannot see? Then that thing, it's proven that they go to those bad places. People get it from there. That is why, you know, people who usually take drugs, too much drugs, finally, they suffer from many diseases. And they die from those diseases. And then, those who usually go to the wrong places, like nightclubs and those other where there's a drink and that stuff, they always suffer from many, many diseases. And that's real disease, it's very clear. But then, that one is, it's also, you see now it is it's physical. You can even touch it and can see it. And it's scientifically clear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Quran that Shaitan, he always puts us into the wrong way. And we suffer from that. Before we even go, before we get the recording day, Allah says, وَيُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَنْ يُضِلَّهُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. And Shaitan wants them to influence them to the wrong path and to make them in loss. And then when that person gets the Shaitan, the person even gets sick, becomes sick. And that's where many people say, I have been affected by the jinn. And so jinn lives in there. And that jinn they mean is the Shaitan, because they give them the opportunity to have rooms in there. And there are persons, like Allah says in the Quran, in the case of Nabila Ayyub, he says, إِنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ بِنُصْبٍ وَعَذَابٍ. إِنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ بِنُصْبٍ وَعَذَابٍ. Indeed, Shaitan touched me with fatigueness and banishment and like a fire. And all those things are like the person who have been influenced by the Shaitan, he is traumatized. He is not normal. And Allah says in the Quran many verses in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah says, كَالَّذِي يَتَخَطُّهُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ الْمَسْءِ. Like the one who Shaitan had thrown him from top place. And another verse, Allah says, كَالَّذِي اسْتَهْوَتْهُ الشَّيَاطِينُ له حيران له. The person who has been influenced by the shaitan is in confusion. He is running up and down. So come to, because of the time, let's focus on the points. Where are the gates of the shaitan? The gates of the shaitan, first, number one is about food. Eating food, and making money in order to buy food, anything related to money making, food. That is the first gate shaitan sets for us. And if we do not prevent it, then that's where he can defeat us. Allah is telling us that in the Quran. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس كلوا مما في الأرض حلالا طيبا ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Oh, you human being, Allah is talking now to all mankind, not specific to Muslims. And so this notice is to all mankind, not specifically to those who believe in and those who are good. Allah is saying, oh mankind, eat from the earth, whatever you get it from the earth, which is halal and tayyib, which is permissible, halal, and at the same time tayyib, which is good for your health, for your nutrition and for your security. Eat that one. And then Allah says, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. And do not follow the footsteps of the shaitan. Do not follow the small steps of the shaitan. Allah, because the street is very clear. There are small angles there, so do not follow those small parts. The other gate is the gate of security and peace. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking now to specifically to the Muslims, saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. Oh, you who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, enter the peace collectively, all of you. None of you can stay outside. You, all of you should go to the peace. And that peace is the same as Islam, which is, you are practicing it at exactly the way it is. That's real peace. And when you enter that peace, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطْوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ, and do not follow the footsteps of the shaitan. So now, for general is for all people. And now for Muslims, if you enter this Islam and you really practice it the way it is, then do not follow the footsteps of the shaitan. And also, do not, it enters there for your interaction with the people, your political activities, and also even in religion, when you are in studying Islam, and even when you are teaching Islam, it goes into that way also. Even in teaching in Islam, coming to the masjid, that itself, the shaitan is not letting you go there. He will try to enter you in that way also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us also in the Quran, that shaitan said, لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. Indeed, I swear, I will sit for them in front of the right ways, the right path. When they are going to the masjid, I will sit and just right in front of the masjid and wait for them there. But there are ways to prevent all that, and inshallah, I will detail that, how to prevent it, how to avoid it. I will talk about it in the next Friday sermon, inshallah. But this today is, first we have to identify it. We have to know it is ways. Then after that we will talk about how to prevent it. And in terms of the security is that, it comes to the way of the security. So it will force you to hit someone, to insult someone, to curse somebody, to do this, this, that. Because of it, this is the way of the security. And inshallah, I will complete after Jalsat Taraha, أقول قول هذا واستغفر الله واستغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, I will mention three gates that Shaitan uses to enter us and to influence us. Those three gates, the first we said it comes anything about related to food and living things, livelihood. So it's about livelihood, property, all that. That livelihood included also the children and family. The Shaitan says, Allah gave him the opportunity, وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ. Even share with them their property and their children. So he shares, he takes share in our property and our children. Why? If we do not prevent it, it will come to them and then it will influence your children and it will come to your food and it will eat with you and so many things. But then, that is in many ways. In one way, it shows you a window of poverty. It says to you, no, don't waste this money. You will feel poverty. You will become so destitute. Don't pay this money. Keep it. No, get another money. Take that one from home. Take this from here and there. Collect money. So in that way, it shows you poverty. And Allah is telling us that in the Quran, that he says, الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر. الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر. الشيطان is calling you for poverty, which doesn't even exist. It shows you mirage of poverty. It will say to you, next year there will be a strike, there will be so and so, and then you have to save money now, because there is a drought coming. There is such and such things coming. So then it will put you into that problem. In another way, if you succeed in that and you defeat him, then he will come from another door also. Then he will say to you, no, money is nothing. Pay it, throw it, it's nothing. Then you will become, Allah says, Mubadhir. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Those who are Mubadhir, the one who is wasteful, all the time throwing out money for no reason ever, buying everything that he or she sees for the sake of buying. That person is called, is a wasteful loser, and he will make you that. So he took you from that extreme to another extreme, and you were supposed to be in the middle, always like that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that in the Quran, always you must be like this. وَلَا تَبْسُدْهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ فَتَقْرَ. Do not make your hand, وَلَا تَجْعَلْ يَدَكَ مَغْلُولَةً إِلَىٰ عُنُقِكَ. Do not make your hand, the one which is connected to your neck, like this. And وَلَا تَبْسُدْهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ. And do not spread it like this. And so فَتَقْرَدَ مَلُومًا مَحْسُورًا. Then it will make you completely run out of money, everything. You will not pay another sadaqah, because you already wasted it. You must be always like this, like in blood. So the third gate is the gate of that he uses us in our talking, falling into sins, crimes, and antisocial behaviors, and all that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Oh, you who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not follow the footsteps of the shaitan. ومن يتبع خطوات الشيطان. And anyone who follows the footsteps of the shaitan, فإنه يأمر بالفحشاء والمنكر. The shaitan will order him to be immoral, to be someone who is not even thinking, planning, and also acting as immoral and antisocial behaviors, always doing antisocial behaviors. I will conclude in telling that there are many ways. And I think I cannot complete it now, but first we have to know that Shaitan has so many gates to use to interfere our activities. And it also uses many tricks, many methodologies. Among the methodologies, just to make it quickly, is that what is called that he makes it resemblance of the bad things, he shows you something which is almost the same. He says to you, no, this is like this one, don't worry. Like a riba is like a business, so there's not much difference. Then that's one way. The other way, he plays around the wordings. Say, no, that is that word, it's not good. But this word is good. But he's changing the words and using it that way. Another way is that he makes marketing to advertise that. We see all the advertisers on TV, so he makes that. Advertise through TV, through everywhere, in your mind. That is another way. Another way he makes it tazim, to beautify something, to decorate, and use that decoration and beautification. Another way is that he uses what's called tawakkul, is that you just depend on something. You say, I depend on Allah, I will save, Allah will do this one. And then you are not taking any action. That is another trick he's playing. Another way is kasmi, is that you are so fatigued all the time and tired. And another way is that you are, and which is intention you have. And another way is that he uses a ru'ya, like the dream is hulu. And the Prophet says, a ru'ya salih min Allah wal hulum min al-shaytan. That hadith brought by Bukhari is that he uses he gives you some dreams. Then you'll say, I have seen that in the dream, so I must do it. So dreams cannot put you into good action. In all that, about the life. أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل وأحذركم بنفسي ونفسكم بمخالفة الله وإحسانه. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والفحشاء إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. ويعظكم أن تدعوه وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن